new tramway track here in Saint-Denis. I've done clips here before, but I haven't been here in a long time. I'm not out very much anymore. And these tramways are not taking anyone anywhere currently. They're just checking the viability of the new track which has been laid and which isn't finished. I think this line runs up to Épinay sur Seine. I don't recall. It's the tramway 8. There must be about 14 to 20 tramways in and around Paris now. When I moved here 20 years ago, there were only two of them. They're very, very handy. I really like them. So I want to make a clip about a problem I just had. I don't know what time it is. Oh, wow, it's already 4:30. I've been out for almost 2 hours. It's going to take me a long time to get home. This is probably something Americans may want to know if they go to live and work in France, or even if you're here on vacation or to study, whatever. And that is, all right, you still have a U.S. bank account and you're still a U.S. citizen, but you're over here for some period of time. Oh, it might even be a short period of time and something comes up. But you might be like me, and you might be a French citizen now and have dual citizenship, and you don't go back to the United States anymore, but you're still American, and you have one little checking account over there, say, which I do, which doesn't even earn any interest, and the fees on it are high. So about every year or so, I put a small amount of money in there to pay the very, very, very few, like there are like two, maybe three a year, bills that I still have to pay in the USA. Because you can do a cash mandate, which is, well, the postal mandates they don't do anymore here. They haven't done them for about 4 years internationally. But it's a big hassle to do it via the post office, particularly my post office. And whenever I have to do this here, I have a monumental problem getting my French bank with a family checking account over here in France, which we've had for 21 years, I believe, to a wire transfer over to this U.S. bank account. It's always hell. It is always hell. And yet I have to do it sometimes. The problem today was, I started trying to do this yesterday, and at the post office it didn't work. They were missing some numbers and stuff. So I went back home and I called the United States, I called the bank, and I just want you guys to know, 800 numbers are not toll free from France. 888 numbers don't work at all. Those other special numbers don't work at all. But, so you should have with you the regular international UPay phone number to call from France, and probably a lot of other countries. You will pay. There is a way you can do 800 numbers from here, but you still pay. And I said to him, you know, this problem is coming up again. I've written about this before. Nothing is done about it. There are, on average, 1 million Americans in France at any given time. And this is no good. What I need from you guys is a numéro clé and a numéro IBAN. And I know that the terms are different in different countries. I have worked in banking in more than one country, but it's like a key code, and which is usually two digits, and it's a very long identifying number, which starts with a couple of letters, such as FR for France, and might be USA for the United States. And I was on hold for a long time, yesterday and today. And I was told today that the information that I was given on the phone was correct and should suffice. And I said, well, it doesn't. And I've been here for a long time, and it just doesn't work. They need that IBAN number. So I was back on hold again for a long, long, long time. And I was told that bank doesn't use them, and that American banks don't use them. And I said, well, this French bank wants one. And I've been told that all French banks will want one. And I know this happens. You know, there are things that happen when you get married or when you do banking or all sorts of things where it just doesn't exist in another country. It does not exist. I didn't know what to do. So I waited and waited, and I saw another employee in an office. And she figured out how to do it, but it seemed to take an incredibly long time that I was sitting in there. So she printed it out for me again, but the last time I could remember that this was done was about 4 years ago. It may have been done more recently, but I don't really remember. And I could remember about when it was done, but that information was too old. They didn't have the complete information anymore. Just wasn't there anymore. And I didn't have the piece of paper anymore. You know, 4 years is a long time. So I have it again. It seems to have gone through. Now, I just want to let you know that what I could have done was taken one of my French checks, filled it out, made it payable to myself for the amount in euros that I wanted to give to myself in the United States, and sent it regular first class mail over there, or registered mail, with a deposit slip and a proper letter explaining why I was doing this, and that I had spoken to the bank and I had endorsed it properly and put my account number on the back properly. But that will take a long time to get over there, about a week to 2 weeks, 3 days to 2 weeks, and it will take an incredibly long time for the foreign check to clear. Of course, it's a check from you to you, and they will really take a lot of money out for doing that. I mean, I have done that before, and it's very painful. And I remember when I moved here to France, I went to see that bank, and I said, okay, this is what I'm doing. I'm all squared away here. I am expatriating. How can I get my money once I'm in France? And they said, well, it's no problem, just call us. That wasn't true. That was told to me by a young lady named Ms. Cancel, C-A-N-C-E-L, like cancel a check. Oh, I'm so angry at her. That was completely false. You cannot call from another country and say, hi, it's me, I want to wire some money over to myself here. I got a French bank account, I'm going to get married, we're going to buy an apartment. You know, that doesn't work. Why would they tell me that? And I asked more than once. Julia Cancel, her name was. I'd love to get my hands around her throat. So what I had to do was write this big check or something to my French fiancé. We weren't even married yet. You know, this was potentially very risky. And he deposited it in, it was either his new bank account or our new bank account. I think it was ours. But we weren't married yet. Maybe we were. I don't remember. This was over 20 years ago. And, you know, you just absolutely get gouged. You know, and after paying off all my U.S. taxes, it was $14,000. Moving my stuff over, which was necessary, was about $13,000. Squaring away my bills, my life, changing all my IDs, getting all the necessary stuff done, subletting my apartment, which I did let go 14 months later. And then buying an apartment over here with my husband. I mean, we were down to our last equivalent of $200. No, I don't want this bus. No. It only goes one more stop. So you really have to think about this stuff when you go abroad. And also remember, please, that if you lose your credit card or debit card or stuff like that, and you're over here, I can say this, you are in a world of hurt. Okay, I'm going to turn this off.